Alright guys, got some sick beats here for you. It's what I class as just good quality, funky, get down and do your stuff. Alright, so what I'm going to do here in this tutorial is I formed a loop on this track here. Going to let this play a little bit, going to bring the loop in, and then that gives me the time to bring in the next track. Both of them amazing, Grandmaster Flash feature versus Royksopp. On the right-hand side. So first of all, let's listen to Party Black Rocker. Okay, Royksopp. Oh, man, this is to die for. It's just like... What is going on, man? I'll tell you what's going on. There is so much good music out there, old and new. Like, just open your ears. Man, that is some shit hot, hot shit. Seriously. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to try and make this as simple and as quick as possible, but... I want to bring in Grandmaster Flash over the Block Rocker, but I've got a loop going here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to let this track play, bring the loop in, and then bring Grandmaster Flash over it. I'm going to do it two different ways. First way, you can sort of hear that I'm bringing a loop in. The second way, you cannot hear the fact that the loop is coming in. I guarantee that. 1,000,000%. So first of all, let's just go put this forward a bit. I'm not using headphones as well, by the way, so quite rough. Let's go to loop. I'm going to do this three times. Okay, so there's my loop. The loop's right from the beginning of the track. But what I did do there that was proved it was rough is I just I waited for the end of a phrase and just brought that loop in. So what we had a lot going on to nothing. So the analogy there, it's a little bit like you're walking along cliff face, boom, you hit the floor. Whereas what we want to do is we would just want to have a smooth... transition. You know, it's almost as though you're still on this level plane, even though you're doing a mix. The next mix now, instead of like just a dive, we're going to go down some stairs. So you will be able to hear a difference, but let's say not as in your face. So, but again, here, what we need to do is find a better place to bring the loop in. Ah, less going on. Two. Three, four. Much better. Okay. So do you see there what we had? We had a really kind of interesting break, a breakdown of the track. And then that gave me the opportunity just to bring that loop in. Let it play for a bit. Okay, so let's try and do it a little bit better again. This time I'm going to use the filter. So let's go forward. Now at the moment I'm right at the beginning of the track. All my life I've been waiting. Let's go back a bit. Alright, I'm adding to this video, I do apologise, but then randomness is the key. So what I've done there is I've added two hot cues. Now, bearing in mind, You can use hot cues while the track is playing and people are listening to it, but on the other hand, it's always better to do your loops and your hot cues while you're on the headphones getting it ready. So, for example, not the Royxop tune, but say there's another track here playing, you're getting the party block ready, do your loops, your hot cues there while you've got them on the headphones, and then, of course, you play this. And it's already ready, so you don't have to think, damn, I should have done a hot cue there. When it's gone past, it's too late. Headphones prior to playing it is so much better. Okay, so let's speed it forward a bit. In fact, let's pretend we've played it all. We're going to go towards the end. Probably a better idea. Use a filter. Let it roll through one more time. Oh, the man.